Daily Devotion with Pastor Bala for July 22nd, 2021 from Psalm chapter 24, The Earth Belongs to the Lord. Verse 1, The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and those who dwell therein. For he has founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers. The psalmist states by starting that everything belongs to the Lord. By the way, that also includes us. You see, often we think of ourselves as the owners of things, you know, of our car, our house, or even of our own body. But the reality is, God indeed is the owner of everything on the earth. Verse 3, Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord? And who shall stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not lift up his soul to what is false, and does not swear deceitfully. The psalmist is basically making his case that we are not God, and that we are not perfect. But God is perfect. And so that means we can't be the creator or owners. God is the creator. And while it may be obvious, yet our sinful nature often likes to think that we are in charge. However, God is the ultimate authority. Now, to be fair, God does delegate some of this authority to us. He delegates to us certain responsibilities to take care of, things like the family, the home, and we have responsibilities at work and in our community. But in it all, God is truly the owner of all. Verse 5, He will receive blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. Such is the generation of those who seek him, who seek the face of the God of Jacob. You see, when we realize that we are not God, verse 5 notes that we will receive blessings and salvation. And it is true that God does indeed bless all people. Even the wicked people are still blessed by God. However, only believers in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will have eternal life. The response, verse 7, Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O gates, lift them up, O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts, he is the King of glory. Gates and doors? These are illustrations. Gates and doors are used to keep people in or out. And so the psalmist is basically implying that people should recognize and not deny who is this King of glory, that is, the God Almighty. Again, our sinful nature is indeed strong, and we still like to think, we're God. And when we do that, we are shutting God out, like closing the door or closing the gate. And we like to think that it all belongs to us. So the psalmist notes that we should stop resisting who God is so that the King of glory may come in. It is interesting, even though God created us, God does not force himself upon us. Instead, God does allow himself to be resisted by humans, and you could say a few angels also. The rest of creation really has no choice, and they must obey God. So why does God allow us to resist him? Because God is love, and God is a God of love. And love does not force itself upon other people, but love is freely given. And God wants us to love him. So God then must allow us to even say no to God. So this psalm, we are encouraged to realize that God is the Creator, and we are just the creation. And as the Creator who loves and blesses us, we receive these blessings. And you could say, then it is our duty to thank and praise Him, to let Him in, and to recognize Him for who He is, the Creator, because all of this belongs to Him. God's peace and many blessings be with you, and thank you for listening. And please take an opportunity to share this message with others. If you have enjoyed these daily devotions, please consider making a donation to Peace Lutheran Church, 24024 West Main Street, Plainfield, Illinois, 60544. Thank you again for listening.